students, now our next chapter is chapter 7, that is fractions. Now you already know about basics about fractions that you have already studied in earlier standard, but let me revise you in short. Now what is a fraction? A fraction is actually a part of a whole number. So a fraction is a part of a whole. It represents one or more equal parts of a whole object. For example, I have an apple and I cut it into 5 equal parts. And so what does it mean that if I have only one object and I make 5 equal parts or 3 equal parts or a specific number of equal parts of it, it can be represented in form of fractions. Similarly, I have drawn here a square that is divided into 4 equal parts. This square, whole square, is divided into 4 equal parts. So in all there are 4 squares. Now, if I want to represent the colored object, the colored square, I have selected one out of 4 squares. So how can I represent it? I can represent it as 1 by 4. Or you can say 1 is to 4. Now, 1 here is the numerator and 4 is the denominator. And the line between the numerator and denominator is called fraction part. Now, numerator, what is numerator? It is number of parts being referred. Which is the colored part? How many colored parts do you see here? Only 1 square? So, numerator is number of parts being referred. Here, which part is being referred or how many number of parts is being referred? Only 1. So, number of parts being referred. That is 1. That is numerator. What is denominator? Total number of equal parts. There are total 4 squares. So 4 is total number of equal parts, which is our denominator. Now, how can you compare two fractions, whether one is smaller than other or greater than other? For example, here I have written 3 fractions, 6 by 11, 8 by 11 and 9 by 11. Now, how will you decide which one is greater or which one is smaller? So, to compare, first let us look here. Let us look here and observe that in all the fractions, in 6 by 11, 8 by 11 and 9 by 11, our denominator is same, that is 11. So, in comparison of two fractions or more fractions with same denominator, the fraction with greater numerator is greater. So when there is same denominator in two fractions or in more fractions, we need to check the numerator. The fraction with greater numerator is greater. So in all the three numerators, that is 6, 8 and 9 is greater. So 9 is the greatest out of all three. Then 8 is greater than 6 and 6 is the smaller one. So I have written it in ascending order. Now let us look into the next example. In this example we have same numerator, 2 by 3, 2 by 7 and 2 by 9. Now in case when the numerator is same in fractions, the fraction with smaller denominator is greater. When we have same numerator in the fractions, we check denominator. And the fraction with smaller denominator is greater fraction. So, out of 3, 7 and 9, 3 is the smallest denominator, then 7 and then 8 is the bigger one. So, our fraction 2 by 3 is actually greater than 7 and then 9. So, when there is same denominator, we check the numerator, and when there is same numerator, we check the denominator. But in case of same denominator, the numerator with greater digit is greater, and in case of same numerator, the fraction with smaller denominator is greater fraction. Now, how to find 1 by 2 of 48, or you can say half of 48 grams. So, 1 by 2 into 48. Now 48 is numerator, you can say our number, whole number. So 48 by 2, because 1 plus 48 is 48, so 48 by 2 which is equals to 24. We have just divided 48 by 2. Similarly, 1/3 part of 99, that is, we have to divide 99 into 3 equal parts. So 99 divided by 3, and we get 33 rupees, because here rupees is given in the unit. Now find half of 60 minutes. You already know half of 60 minutes is 30 minutes, but how we find it for greater numbers, the method is such. So 1 by 2 of 60 is 60 by 2. So we have divided 60 with 2 and we get 30 minutes. So in this way, a fraction is a whole and it represents one or more equal parts of a whole object. And the fraction is represented in a form of numerator and denominator.